Thank you. Thank you, Rutherford Next, for hosting this forum. Basically, what I want to tell you is I want to serve my city. Dale and I have been here since 1986. We've raised our family here, and my grandkids are here now as well. And with a bachelor's degree and a master's degree from the University of Michigan and over 30 years of experience in financial services, I am well qualified for this position. As manager of an 11-state region, I have personal responsibility for over $160 million in assets, and I manage all of the advisors in that territory. I'm skilled in research, strategic planning and analysis, and I understand zoning and economic development. I can help Roswell achieve robust and smart growth. I bring private sector experience to the City Council, but I also have dealt with City Hall through a decade of volunteer service. I'm a member of the Roswell Initiative for Community Housing, and that was recognized by the mayor this week for our work on housing and neighborhood revitalization. As president of a large HOA, I took them from a financial instability to a long-term surplus. I've helped neighborhoods and developers create good projects around the Coleman Road that have the support of the people. And I look forward to helping Roswell grow and prosper. Thank you.
Mr. Horton, your closing remarks, please.
Again, thanks to Roswell Next and everybody that came out tonight to hear about this important election. Roswell is a great place to live. Everybody here will agree to that. But I feel that there are some on City Council who are just on the wrong track about the kind of city the people of Roswell want to live in. They changed their zoning codes, and in the process, they jeopardized the very things that give Roswell the appeal it has. If we don't do something about it now, it's going to be too late by the next election. We are already making profound changes. For example, if you look at the historic district, instead of 35% lot coverage in the old zoning code, it's now 70%. That's double what it was. Density was removed as a limitation in the code. So now we're going from one or two houses to an acre, to five or six, and in some cases, 7 to 10. And we're doing this next to some of our established neighborhoods. And why do we need to do that? Let me be clear, we do need development, but our focus is wrong. We are neglecting blighted areas all over Roswell, and I say, let's redevelop them. Today, 88% of our workforce in Roswell can't afford to live in Roswell. In fact, many of us have kids that can't afford to live in Roswell. But the new developments that we're seeing are all about $400,000 cottages or $600,000 townhomes and higher. Instead, we should be looking at redevelopment that will create housing for young families and professionals who are the future of our city. But in order to do that, we're going to need a change on City Council. You have a lot of choices for post three, but I believe I'm the most qualified candidate to deal with these issues. And that's with my over 30 years of experience in business and over a decade of service to my community. I've worked with a number of groups, including the Roswell Initiative for Community Housing, so I know what some of the housing needs are. I've helped neighborhoods and developers come together and create good projects that have the support of the people. I know and understand zoning and development from both public and private sector point of view, and I want to bring business experience, not just government experience, into city operations. Most important, if you elect me, I will represent your interest on these issues.